Hello viewers and learners, I extend a warm welcome to the present module on Digital Assessment Tools Part 2. With today's greetings, I am Professor Naseeb Singh Gill from Department of Computer Science and Applications and Director, Digital Learning Initiatives and Monitoring Cell of Maharshi Dayanand University, Rohtak, Haryana. Assessment are the central process of instruction and bridge of teaching and learning in educational experience. Effective assessments are just like a thermometer to measure learners' progress regarding their understanding of the contents and determines their ability. It is a matter of concern that construction of effective assessment takes a lot of time and becomes an issue of heavy workload too. In this age of digital learning, technology may contribute maximum in carrying out digital assessment and feedback practices, which would in turn result into a responsive, efficient, attractive, and time-saving practice. As discussed in previous modules, digital assessment tools are gaining good popularity. Educational experiences are now becoming vicarious and marvelous due to these tools. Technology can help teachers track and assess the performance of their learners in the classroom. The present module is focused on practical understanding of digital assessment tools. Though there are several popular tools for digital assessment, but few of the tools to name are very popular, and which includes Google Forms, Kahoot, Quizlet, Life, Socrative, Nearpod, and ZipGrid. So before we proceed further, let's enumerate the learning outcomes of this particular module. Learners will be able to understand digital assessment. A sense of digital assessment in 21st century. Using digital assessment tools and popular tools for digital assessment. And then finally, working with Google Form and Kahoot with a practical session. Now let's step forward towards another important digital assessment tool, and that is Google Forms. Google Forms is a widely used tool for student assessment. And Google Forms allow teachers to create multiple choice questions in the form of a survey and enhance it with images and videos quickly within a few minutes. They can also add collaborators to their Google Forms and work on a survey together. Google Forms is a survey administrator app that is included in the Google Drive Office Suite. Google Forms is a tool that allows collecting information from users via a personalized survey or quiz. The information is then collected and automatically connected to a spreadsheet. The spreadsheet is PopKey feature. And what it indicates within your spreadsheet window, it could be showing multiple choice, short answers, rating, date, ranking, like questions. It assigns correct answers and comments for answer choices. Assign point values for each question. Built-in math keyboard for writing equations. So in the nutshell, Google Forms can be created quickly, it can be maintained, it can be analyzed, and it can help as a very easy and handy tool to respond back. And even the students can fill in the Google form quickly, and it could be immediately responded. So in this way, it will be a win-win situation for both teachers and the collaborators and the stakeholders. So now let's switch to the practical session on Google Forms, as how quickly we can create a Google Form. Friends, let me welcome you to the digital assessment tool that is one of very, very important such tool is Google Forms. And that is very convenient and easy, as I discussed. Now let me take you to the practical session for that. What you have to do is how to locate Google Forms, how to create it. Let me show you afresh within 8 to 10 minutes. You can search it on the website. And here, if you search in the search engine, Google Forms. Here it shows you Google Forms, and you can click it. What it will do is, it will require you to go to Google Forms, and you can directly go to Google Forms. And what it shows, here it shows Forms, Slides, Sheets, Docs. If you say go to Google Forms, it will take you to Google Forms, for which you have to have an account. If you don't have, you have to create it to make use of the Google Forms. If you already have an account, let me demonstrate you. What you have to do is, you have to log in your account. So it will take you to your Gmail account. And it has taken you directly to the Google Forms, if you already had an account. And what it shows here is start a new form. Here, these are contact information, RSVP, party invite. So these are some of the standard templates. These are gallery that it shows. And if you have a look at it, it just shows you several ready-made forms that you can make use of. Here the different themes, different templates that you just do find. If you are interested to create your own account, you have to press this button. But let me share with you that when you are visiting the website and going to our Google Forms, you can directly go to, as I just mentioned. But if you are having your Gmail, for example, if you are logged into your Gmail, from there also you can go to the Google Forms. Let me tell you the route through which you can switch to. Observe, this is showing your Gmail account. That's why you have just got an event from Gmail has been added to your Google Calendar, because this was the activity we didn't create. We had just created. That's why it has been sent an email here. Now, let me tell you that if you are just working with the Gmail, how you can locate your Google Forms. Look at this. This is your Google Apps. Here is the drive. If you press the button Drive, what it will? It will take you to the same options as we were already provided. drive.google.com, and here what it will show you? It will show you the different options here. And what are the options you have been served? Here is the application forms. These application form and responses. These are the different. Already these are few of the options within the drive which you have been already shown here. If you want to go for our Google Forms, if I am saying Google Forms, you can locate. This is a kind of form. Here, if you just look at the different options, it will show you the grid options. These are the different view details. These are the different options that you can have. Here, what you can have, you can add our different activities. These are the different docs. These are the different, if you say, under this, if you observe Google Docs, Sheets, and under more, what you find? Google Forms. Here, under this, you just find a blank form or from template. So, this is your choice. You have seen already different templates. Let's learn as how to create a form. We have clicked blank form. What it will show you? It will show you the window. What has been shown? Untitled form. For example, if you want to describe what it is, let's say here we are writing application form. For example, what kind of form description you are writing? If you want to write, it is an application form for admission. And what you have been shown here, have a look at. These are the different options. What you can do? These are different options that you can add. If you have a look at on this side, this is a button. What you can do? You can add a question. For example, name. Now what you can have, there are different options. So if you just say, the name should be what? Short answer, paragraph, multiple choice. So looking at the option, what is relevant to you, you can put in. For example, this is short and you have done. If you want to say you want it, yes, required, do this. And now add another field. For example, say date of birth. Now what should be the template? And here you have been shown automatically the date. But if you want to change, if it is date or something else, you can change it. But see, it is date, that's why you say it's a date. And what you say, it's your required. It's fine. And what you do? Now it's okay. If, for example, if you say you want to end it, so it means it is not required. And what you say? You delete it. It has been deleted. And what you are doing? You just particular save it. So when you are doing it, it shows what kind of customized theme you want to use. This is the theme that you want to use. For example, if you want to background, it can change. It can change accordingly. Similarly, these are the different option settings that you can do. This is the different options that it can show you that how it will look like. It's a preview. So this is how the form will look like. And what you can do? You can submit it. So this is the way that what you could see that how you can enjoy the form, how you can create it, and you can accordingly submit it. So this was the response sheet that which was available to you. So friends, I hope with this small session you would have enjoyed that how to create, and automatically you will also be receiving the response accordingly. So we just now had a practical session on Google Forms. I hope that you would have enjoyed it. Now, let's proceed towards a practical session that is focused on another game-based learning platform. And that is also one of the very, very important digital assistant tools which is popular among its learners. So I hope that you would have got to which tool I'm pointing. It is Kahoot. Kahoot is nothing but a game-based learning platform which is used as educational technology in schools and other educational institutions. Its learning games, Kahoots, which is known as Kahoots, are multiple choice quizzes that allow user generation and can be accessed via a web browser. Kahoot can be used to review students' knowledge for formative assessment. Kahoot is a tool for using technology to administer quizzes, discussion, surveys, jumbling. So Kahoot is nothing but it is a game-based classroom response system played by the whole class in real time. Multiple choice questions are projected on the screen. Students answer the questions with their smartphones, tablets, or computers. Questions are projected on a shared screen while an unlimited number of players answer the questions with their smartphones, tablets, or computers, creating a social fun and game-like environment. So Kahoot digital assessment tool allows for the design of multiple choice quizzes as well as polls and surveys that populate on the spot data. The quiz questions and polls stimulate quick instructional decisions as well as whole class discussion. As an assessment-based tool, Kahoot supports pre-assessments, productive formative assessments, and student reflection through fun quizzing, quick polls, and surveys. Now, without taking any more time, let me take you to the practical session on Kahoot. Friends, let's move to this practical session on Kahoot creation. What you have to do is go to your web browser and search for Kahoot rather than cramming anything. So you observe Kahoot.com. So press this link. Here you will appear this screen will appear before you, and which I've been showing our several updates. If you have a look at it's your for schools, for businesses, for publishers, for mobile apps, for more. So what you have to do is you have to nothing but understand what exactly this Kahoot is meant for, who can be the real beneficiary. If you have not so far used it, you have to create a Kahoot account. Let us sign up first. I'm taking you to. Now, I want to use Kahoot as a teacher, as a student, at work, or socially. If, for example, because let me demonstrate only one option and through which you can easily switch to any other mode as a teacher. If you want, sign up with the email. If you already have the email account, we can easily switch. If you already have, if you sign up with the email, I can put up. Add your school or university. For example, I am writing MD University. I am writing workplace. Select one. It's your higher education. I am writing here. Writing. name I am putting up like this. Here, add your email address. Suppose I'm putting up my email address. We have to confirm our email address. Let's confirm. What further? We are creating the password. And we have just gone through the instructions and we say join Kahoot. For the particular entries that we have to make, check your entries. What entries you just are required to make here? This is the name. If, for example, I am writing here, it's too short. Please make sure. It is, I am just writing it. Is okay, fine, it's accepted. Join Kahoot. And what will happen? Your account has been created. And you will receive this message. Personalize, if you want to personalize, you can personalize. Or if you say, you can just say, no thanks. So what you will have here, at this particular point, what you have been shown, here you can easily, that is, these are the different what options which are available you can create. If, for example, you have to create, you can create any Kahoot in this way. For example, what do you find? We just indicated that primarily these are the different activities you can perform, like, because it is your game-based learning, so you can create a new Kahoot in the form of the quiz, that is a choose correct answer from multiple alternatives, jumble. Similarly, your surveys, discussions, like this. If, for example, let's choose one activity and you can easily learn the other activities too using your quiz. So you press the link, but it shows title. For example, we are saying it is your IT quiz. Fine. Here what I am writing, I could be writing a question. What is this question? IT quiz description. It is an elementary quiz. If I write, okay, what you are saying, visible to everyone, we can also select it here, to whom. Okay, got it, that you can easily say it should be available. Here you can also choose the language. Here you can choose the whether it's a school, the university, business, or even particularly what is a kind of audience. Here you can put in our the image library. You can upload your image. And what you can have here, you can put in the different kind of theme. So what you can do is, if you say okay fine, you want to create it, you just press this button, okay go. So what it would show, you have to select here. If I am saying the university, you say okay go. If you want to image, you can add an image, or you can just choose this option maybe later. So what it has shown here, image could have appeared. It's an elementary quiz. These are game creator. Now here it is just providing you to what the question you want to add. For example, I'm interested to add the question. What is required here? If you say, who is CEO of Google. Now what time limit, whether you say award, yes or no, that you can choose. If say we are writing here, say Bill Gates, if I'm writing
from the patch I. Here, if we say these are names we put in. Now, which one is correct? For example, if you say these are correct answer, then you have to select it. Now, what the credit resource you can add here accordingly. If you say no, fine, it's okay. These are first question, is it 22nd that is there, and what you do? Then you can just go to the next. So what have been shown here? You have been shown this is a question that will be available, and here you can edit this question. Here you can duplicate the question, you can delete it also. And for example, you just want to add any question, you can also add to this. So automatically, if you just press this link, you will also be served this option. If you say no, you don't want, you can move. Then okay, fine, we can close it. Okay, discarding this question, so you are left with only with question. If you say save, fine, save it. If you want to edit it, preview it, so let's preview it, what it shows. It will be showing this one. That's how it will appear. Like, this is the IIT quiz, this is how, this is a particular, where you have to indicate our this pin number. So that is, this is what you have to do. This is the IIT quiz, and here, for example, this is what, classic. If for example, classic is means, it is your one-to-one device. Here is what, team versus team, shared mode. So these are the different game options which have been provided that you indicate that what are the answers accordingly. So that's why you automatically go for it. For example, if you select classic mode only. So what means, it will go to individual who are ready to join. And that's why what you can do, you can start it and you can just accordingly, this is what, this is the number. If I am saying this is the number that is available, and you have to start it. If you start it, you have to provide this number. Where you have to provide it? Here, this is the game pin. If for example you write this game pin 83278 57, if you say enter, what will happen? It is connecting to this Kahoot. And what your nickname, for example, you are writing like this. Okay, what do you find? Yes, you are in. So what do you do have? This person is available. If you start the game, this question will go to there, to that person, and this is the question that will, who is CEO of Google, and this is here what you find, and this is what you have to do is, you have to accordingly select which answer is correct. For example, you say you select this option, and what is it? It is wrong, incorrect answer. So this is how you can do, and it means if you press next, it will be showing the zero score. So I hope in this way you can use this Kahoot for even your jumbling, for surveys, and for your quiz kind of activities. Hopefully this small session, practical session, would have made you to a comfortable level of understanding as how to create a Kahoot account and how you can use it for the purposes which is completely based on your game based learning process. Thanks a lot.
I hope this practical session on Kahoot would have been quite fruitful and useful for you. So this was the magic of digital assessment tools. And by enjoying onto our this practical session and that too live on your Google Forms and Kahoot, it would have certainly added to your confidence. Now let us sum up the entire module in the nutshell. In this module, we have discussed in detail about digital assessment tools by focusing on understanding digital assessment, a sense of digital assessment in 21st century, our these popular tools for digital assessment, and that too, again, a practical session on your Google Forms and Kahoot. Thanks a lot, learners and viewers, for enjoying this module, as well as your active participation in this module. We will soon join you with another important module on pedagogical innovations and research methodology. Thank you.